Negative traffic, only 410, negative 6, runway Brigitte.
Pineda traffic, German Air Force 66 X-ray joining the final 4 runway 16 left on the RNM.
Narita traffic, Smithville 8 Lima Mike, lining up and taking off runway 16 right, Peacock 2 departure, Narita traffic.
Narita traffic, United 8. 75 heavy is level 170. Approaching Pollux for the Pollux 1 Delta arrival, runway 22 in the rear. Alrighty. What's up, guys? How is it going over there? Can get down to 8.
Narita traffic on the bin 8 heavy, take off 16 right, Narita.
Yeah, I've got a mic. I just had to set it up here. No cam for now. It is a Sunday after all. So we'll be doing the ILS runway 22 into Narita, Pollux 1 Delta arrival. Just gonna turn down the bass a little bit on my microphone here. So
Narita traffic, I do 11, taking off runway 16 left on the road for 2 Alpha departure. Narita traffic.
Turn the brightness down on this thing here. Okay, so we're going to do flaps 30 landing today. Approach speed is 140 plus 5. That's going to be our VRF plus 5, 145. And then we're going to plan on a on vacating on, I think, Bravo 6. Bravo 8 might be a little bit tight. So we'll do Bravo 6. And then Mike, Papa to Terminal 3. So we'll plan on Bravo 6. We'll see what happens here. We'll leave it at auto brake too. That should be good. Okay, level 100, lights on. Good. Take them down to 5,000, which is mandatory. Nifty. Nexus, rather. That is a huge engine. Cabin's ready, checked. Canada traffic, United 875. We're about 20 miles north of Nexus. Currently 8,000, descending to 5,000. We'll report established ILS 22, Canada. This is wrong. Triple seven's a huge plane, makes sense. Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I think I remember that. That is super cool. It's quite the plane to fly. Super capable. I forget what airline she flies for. Is that FedEx? Okay, runway 22 is in sight. Flaps one. Approach mode. Although I'm not getting an ILS reading. I don't quite like that. So for some reason, .277, that seems wrong. Weird. Flaps 5. Yeah, I was not getting a reading on the other frequency though. That's wrong. Haneda traffic, United 875 Heavy is established ILS runway 2213 DME, Haneda. Yeah, so it populated the wrong ILS frequency and course. So it looks like there's a database thing there. Now we're having to manually descend down to the glide. There's a little bit of speed break there to this down. Apparently there's... Oh, good memory. Awesome. Yeah, FedEx is sweet, man. Sterilock cockpit, yeah. Alrighty, thank you very much. I'll try my best here. Haven't flown this beast in a while. Okay, speed checks, flaps 15. Still didn't grab. Gear down. VRF plus
2500.
We're gonna go manual. Out of traffic, United 875 Heavy is 5 miles, ILS runway 22, Haneda. Last time my approach was over the city, which was kind of cool, but this time it seems like we're flying from the back. Okay, gear down, green light, flaps 30, green. I'm slightly to the left and a bit high, so correcting. Quick wing view. I've been saying Haneda, but it's Narita. Narita traffic, United 875, heavy, short final runway 22, Narita. Because there is a Haneda airport as well in Tokyo. This is Narita. I've been saying that wrong. Whoopsie.
400. Approaching minimums. Minimums.
Continue, runway in sight.
100. 50. 30. 20. 10.
Reverse idle. And we went all the way to Bravo 2 because of our float. But that's okay. Thank you very much, Kamiqua. Narita traffic, United 875. Heavy is vacated runway 22. Narita. Okay, now before we continue, flight director's off, flaps up. And then get our spoilers up. We'll turn off our strobe, runway turnoffs, landing lights all off. And we'll get our APU going here.
Anita traffic, American 168, heavy is pushing back from stand 132, facing north. Anita.
No, we are in Haneda. Why do I keep mixing up Haneda and Narita? Narita is another airport. So Haneda was right. Haneda's like the main airport. What is the approach for this bird? So we were at... let's see here. 219 tons, so 4-something, 100,000 pounds gross weight, with 10,000 kilos of fuel, or like 20-something on 1,000 pounds. It was 140 plus 5, so 145, which is really not bad. Alright, so Terminal 3, we're going to take a look at our airport chart here. We didn't quite make Bravo 6 because of the float, so I'll make a left to Bravo, Mike Papa. Haneda traffic, United 875 Heavy is going to be taking Bravo, Mike Papa for Terminal 3 in Haneda. Oh, no worries. So for today's approach was 140 plus 5, so 145 for the approach speed. And that's at a gross weight of 219,000 kilograms. Which is really not bad. I mean, even an A321 or so could hit that approach speed. Of course, depending on your gross weight, but... Oh, no worries. So for a gross weight of 219 tons, not sure what that is in pounds, our approach speed was 140 plus 5, so 145 knots. we'll take any of these gates here. I think we can do the gate 112. Set the brake. Confirm the APU is on. The status page here. Up. Yep. All right, clear to shut down.
Need a traffic American 168 heavy taxiing runway 16 left. By Papa Bravo Lima 15 Alpha 15 Bravo correction Kilo crossing runway 16 right at Lima 15.
And that is that. Well, not yet. We gotta turn the beacon off first. There you go. Welcome to Haneda International, or Tokyo International. I think it was just over 11-hour flight time. Beautiful airplane. I'm used to the MD-11, which is about 20 knots faster. Yeah, that bird is not very well, it's aerodynamic. But not as efficient as this wing. Convince Twitch knows when you ask a question of the streamer and it knows to generate an ad to create frustration in the viewer.
542 is static final, runway 23 heading.
I know, right? Yeah, that's annoying. Or like, every time you get on a stream, and right when the streamer's landing, it populates an ad. Eleven-hour flight time, 42-minute stream time. I know, isn't that beautiful? Basically, I'll make this story short, but I upgraded to a new CPU, and I wanted to see how it handles streaming and pretty much do a mini stress test, make sure Flight Sim doesn't crash overnight, so I decided it'd be best to just do a long haul and stream the takeoff and the landing. Haven't really used the showcase camera and I've never had good luck with it. Like right now, I'm not able to move. Banhammer, next stream one. Honestly, I think in about an hour and a half, I need to run an errand, or a couple errands. luckily in the same plaza. And then I'll be back, and I'm thinking we'll either do more MSFS or we'll hop into X-Plane. I haven't flown in X-Plane in a long time because I've been working on optimizing MSFS to its full potential. And I think I've gotten close, so I'll say like an hour and a half maybe.
Narita traffic, all info 1011 is on a short final, runway 16 left.
But before I go...
Narita traffic, American 168 heavy is crossing runway 16 right at Lima 15. Narita, I need it.
See, he's also having trouble with Haneda and Narita. Yeah, hopefully we'll see you on there. If not, then we will see you next time. Let me see here. Keyboard. Drone camera. Translate drone up, right? Ah. Let's see. Ah, okay. But I want this to be... Sorry, I just want to work on this real quick before we finish. Translate up. So I want it to be this. What happens if I do that? Then nothing? I don't see why I can't have... the drone and left. Your ATC sounds are pretty hot compared to your voice and plane sounds. Oh, sorry about that. Yeah, I realized that. So let me turn that down even more. I think we'll set him to like... Yeah, that must be annoying. Set it to like 35 maybe. Sorry about that. Translate drone, and then I want to do... pretty much setting it like X-plane. Because I feel like a lot of thought was put into that. Translate. Then increase. Alright, let's see how that does for now. Okay. Well, that's cool. But I can't rotate it still. And I want to be able to... just louder. Okay, sounds good. Thank you for the heads up. Yeah, my goal is to have every volume level balanced. Last thing, well, that's keyboard, so mouse is gonna be here. Although, hmm. Drone yaw axis. Roll axis. Well, what is this called? Okay, I know what to do now. This won't take long. Drone. Basically, we have to set... yaw drone right. Maybe drone pitch axis, that's why. Let me try this. Z translation axis. Y. Y is up. All right, I think I have to look it up. Maybe it's just yaw. But I already tried that. Right? It's this. I know, I appreciate it. Me too. Oh man, this is like awful. Like basically all I'm trying to do is to be able to rotate this drone camera like an X-plane. Drone yaw axis, axis Y. Yaw axis. I just looked it up on a forum. Drone yaw axis. This must be easier than I thought it would be. Axis. But then, axis Y. Oh. I mean, that's technically what I want. But this is making it I need it to be lockable. But that was it. That was it. Drone. So I need to go into the lockable one. Maybe it's supposed to do that. Drone pitch axis. Let's see.